50 years old. Resolutions. You believe in resolutions?
Yeah, but not in the sense of like New Year, New Me shit. You get me? I'm gonna just say no. I do believe in setting goals and trying to achieve them. I do not believe in resolutions, though. Let's go with that one.
Because you've seen too many people.
Because it's not. I don't think it's just realistic. I think it's you know, a resolution is like you didn't do something that you could have done all 2018. And now the year's coming, you know, you're excited, you know, you have blood pumping through your veins, you're seeing, you know, these inspirational quotes and New Year stuff, and you're like, oh my God, you know what, this year's gonna be mine, I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna do that, and rah, 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 and you put it on Instagram, and you put it on Twitter, and now you feel satisfied, you're like, yeah, I let the world know, and I'm not gonna do nothing about it.
Because in February 1st,
you know, yeah, I forgot, you know, because like that's why I don't believe in resolution. And honestly, when it comes down to even having like big goals, I think that you need to be very like, don't be putting it out there in the world, because I feel like people get comfortable with just saying, you get me? Like, just letting people know, like, oh, this is what I'm up to, you get me? And then they don't actually like,
are actually up to something.
Yeah, exactly. So I believe in setting up goals. I don't believe. You?
I do, I guess, because at least my resolutions are always different. You know, every year I put more resolutions about character than I do about anything else.
Okay.
So I remember, like, for 2018, and I'm pretty sure it's going to continue to 2019, my resolutions were be a better example, be a better leader, be a better friend, be a better neighbor, be a better son. Those were my resolutions.
Then you were the year
before. So my resolutions are very, I guess you could say, general, very vague. But to me, they're also very intentional.
Right.
Because every time I have a situation where I can step up or choose to avoid, is when I gotta remind myself, I said I was gonna be a better this year.
Yeah.
I don't do the whole diet or the whole, like, none of those goals, because I think those goals cannot come from... I do appreciate the impulse of the year that just kind of pushed.
Mm-hmm.
But those goals have to come from a more meaningful place, or else they're not sustainable. They're not going to last.
Yeah.
You get me? They can't be just from the adrenaline rush that comes from a new year or that.
Yeah.
You get me? I do understand that something that push first, but it's still something that will push you consistent after. So let me ask you this. What's the funniest new resolution you've ever heard?
Shit. Man, I put me on the spot. I probably will not remember this. I feel like I don't know if the funniest, just the most common one is always the gym one.
Yeah.
Always the gym one. And what's funny about it to me is that if you got everybody posting the gym selfies, you know, like, oh, back at it, going in strong, motivational quote, and fucking like 2 months down the line, you see the person, you're like, oh, shit, wow. Hey,
you look bigger than before.
Yeah, like what happened, bro? Like,
oh man, all the
holiday eating kind of past, buddy. Like, we're fine, you know.
That's bad.
I think that's probably like anything I can think about.
Yeah.
Like, you ever something funny?
I always find that, you know, like this. I guess I'm just like judgmental. When certain people just like tell me like certain, like, you know, like this is my like that gym one. It depends who it comes from, you know. But certain people come, I'm like, yeah, you know, the last, you know, like,
you just know.
I mean, I know, if they were to offer me a wager, I'll take it, and I'll put all my finances into that, like all that I have, all my life savings into that gamble, because I know it will pay off. I know, like, some of the funny ones I was to find there, like, oh, you know, I'm just gonna make mad money. Like, that's funny to me, because it's not a goal.
That's not a goal.
I'm gonna make mad money. I'm gonna work so hard to make mad money.
Yeah, I'm about to be by my friend. Like,
Like, what is it we're trying to make, like, ghetto? Like, it's like, you know, I'm about my money. I'm about to grind. So, what were you doing all of 2018?
Oh, like, you were just like, for real, you just chilling? Yeah. That's a good point. But, you know, when it comes to all these resolutions, though, it's never really like you said, like, you say you make yours, but I don't think I've ever really heard people be like, oh, I'm gonna try to be a better human being this year. You know, I'm gonna try to be a better, like, I don't really hear people say that. More people be like, you know, this year I'm gonna forget about the boys. I'm gonna forget about the girls. Like, you know, I'm gonna be about my money. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be about me trying to get, you know, 2019. I've seen a lot of tweets so far. 2019 is about, you know, having these edges done and having these nails done and being by my paper. Self-love and self. I like, what the fuck? What the fuck happened to you this year, bro? Like, yo.
You were just rough.
I was just like playing. Like, what happened, bro? Like, don't put me on some crazy shit. I don't know what. Like, what makes them say all this crazy?
That sounds like salty resolution.
Yeah, like self-care. Were you not caring for yourself? Like, this whole year? Like, what happened? I don't know.
That's gonna be wilding. I mean, I'm not making fun of those goals. I'm just saying, like, hit us back in 6 months with us. Gym stuff if you're still going.
Nah, and you won't. Honestly, man, a lot of people fall off because they just, I think a lot of these people fall off from the resolution. They're just in it for the wrong reasons. You get me? They're not in it for the right reasons. Like, your why to continue something that's difficult isn't good enough. You know what I mean? So, like, if you're in the gym to solely look good, that reason better be that big for you to, like, there's days where you just don't want to work out. You don't want to, like, you know, like, that reason better mean that much to you.
For you to drive you through those
Exactly. It has to mean that. So, no, like, some of you guys seen, you guys are losers, bro. Just fucking horrible. Like,
you can't say that, bro.
Why? It's the truth. Like,
it's so bad.
Fucking horrible. I mean, shit.
God.
There's rough out there for y'all. I ain't gonna lie, bro. It's rough. It's been a rough year, but.
Hey, 2019, bro. 2019. This is my year. This is my. That makes me laugh. 2019. This is like, we're like, whatever. It's my year. This is my year.
I think hearing the new year, new me one is the most fun.
No, but for me, like, this is my year. Because, wait, you had the other years, too. They were yours, too, you know?
Like, it's like, just somehow just
they slipped out of your hands.
Guys, look, bro. I'm fucking coughing up like a mother lover right now. My head's on a
blast. La hookah.
No, I ain't no freaking hookah, bro. It's freaking, yo, I don't know what's wrong with you, man. It's been going on for a little, like a week now, bro. Straight coughing.
I see that, bro.
So, I don't know, man.
You're weak. What are the jokes you made this year?
My New Year's resolution is to not cough, not get sick.
No cough ever again. I don't want to cough ever.
For next year, that's going to be my New Year's
resolution. my New Year's resolution is not to get a cold all year.
So everybody wants to make resolutions, yeah, I can't keep any of that. I'm going to try my own. See what happens.
My New Year's resolution is not to have allergies. That's it. I'm going to decide not to have allergies.
I've been telling Chris, man, he can decide not to have allergies. He just
mental. It's all mental, right?
Yeah, he just be tripping. I don't know what's wrong with you, but you should be tripping.
I don't know, I think God gave me a taste of my medicines.
I think so. I'm not lying. I think from chilling with you, bro, that I got this weird, like.
You believe it or me, though.
Yeah, I'm not a lie, bro, because before, like, chilling with you, I never got sick, bro. Yeah. The last two ending of years, I've been, like, sick the worst. It's probably because you're better than saying, no, you.
I don't have to blame.
Yeah, you might have, like, some type of, like, disease.
I ain't going to lie, I'm afraid about this. Well, like, you got me talking too much stuff, man. Make him suffer, though.
See, guys, it's called the devil. You ain't pray about that. You don't pray to the devil.
Nah, you wildin', bro. I gotta do it with me. I know you know me.
Hey, man, so, besides New Year's resolutions, what is the funniest thing so far about this year?
This year?
Yeah. Let's say funniest/fun.
I don't know, man. That Orlando trip, I think, is one of the highlights of my year.
Which one?
The last one, you mean ready?
Oh man, that was good.
I think that was the highlight of my year, bro. That was so funny. That was so bad.
That was fun.
I think that was the highlight of my year.
Nah man, that was fun.
I think that was the highlight. Like when I think about it as like a whole thing, the whole trip was hilarious to me.
Yeah, I think so too, bro. I think that's probably one of the best. Yeah, I think that's the best Orlando trip we took this year for sure. That shit was
hilarious, bro. Funny. Hilarious. It was funny.
Well,
it was fun.
I think one of the funniest moments from this year for me is going to definitely be went to Orlando. And Chris Airbnb got canceled last minute. So he had to book a
room. Oh, yeah. Like, that was quick. Bad.
He had to wait like a quick one. So the place we're going to, like, it looks like it's in a nice, like, neighborhood.
Yeah, it was a setup. Those pictures lied, girls.
It looked nice. I'm like, all right, this place looks decent. You know, not bad. So then we get to the place, and the place is looking like, you know, I'm like, shit. All right, cool. I mean, whatever. It is what it is. You know,
we rented the trap.
Yeah. So, you know, Chris, when he got there, he, you know, he went and he had to, like, do errands with the girls. I don't know. He wanted to go do some shit. And I stayed back like a gangster. I was like, nah, bro, I ain't about that life, bro. You know what I'm saying?
So, oh, that was the one with Sammy, too, right?
Yeah, with okay. Sammy. So, yo, so I go to the gym, you know, come back to the room and whatnot. I take a shower, you know, I'm fresh, chilling, order some food. I'm thinking, all right, cool. And I'm going to wait for these people to get back. I should get back soon. No problem. Yo, somebody, like, probably, like, 20 minutes later, comes knocking on the door. Bah, 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 bah. Oh, shit, that's them. They came already. So, whatever, you know what I'm saying? I go ahead, I open the door. And this is a security guard. But this man is sweating, bro. Like, yo, this nigga, like, over here, like, hey, bro, you all right, man? You all right? I'm like, yo, I'm cool, bro. I'm cool. You know, he's like, yo, nobody broke in here, right? I'm like, wait. No, nobody broke in here. What's going on? He's like, yo, man, they're breaking in through the window. I'm like, yo, so, man, we're on the first floor. We got a first floor thing. I'm like, yo, who's the fuck on? Who's breaking into hotel rooms? Like, randomly through the window. Like, that's, you don't even know.
Is that what you give me, the bed next to the window?
Yeah, I look at that bed right there, bro. Anybody's gonna die first, not gonna be me for sure, bro. Yeah, so I had to sleep with a knife under my pillow.
Yo, that was, I think I tapped you.
I don't know, bro, but I was asleep, and the thing that I'm sleeping, like, kind of like, I'm not like heavy sleep at this point, that I could hear some shit, but I just not, at one point, I kind of like dozed off, like kind of heavy, and I guess like, I don't know, I guess he tapped me or something, I just woke up, look, man, I was about to stab Chris.
Yo, like, you really, I tell you, this guy really pulled out the blade and was about to shake my arm.
Bro, like, I've never ever had to deal with, I'm staying in a hotel and have to worry about hoodlum breaking in. Who are they trying to rob? Like, what are they trying to rob for? Like, it's like, I can understand if you broke into, like, a, you know, like a Ritz Carlton, yeah, a Trump Tower. You know, say you're trying to rob some rich people. You're trying to rob broke college kids. Like, that makes no fucking sense. You about to take sneakers. Then you about to take a pair of Jordans and some boxers, bro. That's what you take.
And my boxers are dirty too, probably.
That's nasty, boy. Yeah, man, I think that's definitely the funniest moment, bro. The fact that you made me stay in the trap for vacation.
Yo, that was a bad one, though.
For vacation. Yo, I'm not gonna lie. It hasn't failed to this day. Every time I go to Orlando with Chris and I want to go to a hot tub, I never go to the hot tub. Because of Chris.
Wait,
it hasn't failed.
Once.
Twice.
Once.
Twice. It happened that first trip, that by the time we got back, the hot tub was closed.
That first trip was amazing. It was because we all took forever. That you're with Eddie, that I said, okay, fine, stay a little longer. That was
Magic
my fault.
Kingdom?
Yeah, that was my fault.
I know that was your fault. What about the second time? The same time we say that it's Magic Kingdom. That was my for your birthday.
How was that my fault?
It was your fault.
No, when we were still for her, it was saying that really, really nice one, right?
Oh, no.
That was Epcot.
Oh, for her birthday.
When we stayed in that birthday.
For
her birthday, we went to the trap house. And you could have gone to the hot tub because you went to the gym.
Yeah.
That wasn't me.
No, I'm talking about the hot tub after the park.
No, that was...
You decided to take us to Magic Kingdom.
No, that was...
Magic Kingdom has the biggest line to
beat
ever.
No, that was the time that Eddie, you, and me went alone. Remember? Yeah, we had that.
Yes, that time too. That was also the other time. Because mind you, Magic Kingdom, you take forever to leave. You have to make a line... To get on the bus.
Yeah.
No, you gotta make a line to get on the train to make another line to get on another train.
The other one was because
you took us to Magic Kingdom. It's your fault all the time.
We were there the whole day.
Why would you take us to Magic Kingdom?
We were literally the only...
Honestly, that's the only reason I don't ever want to go back to Magic Kingdom. Ever. Like, yeah, we're going back to Magic Kingdom. It better be during the day and we better leave at 12. Like, at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, we better get the fuck out of there. Like, leave. Get the fuck out of there. Go somewhere else. Because that shit, yo, I can't have that fuck.
Yeah, living is horrible. The money you take the train or the boat is horrible.
Shit is bad. You see, I'm dying, bro.
Yeah.
You know what? Take over. I don't want to talk no more, man. But
I mean, I don't know, man. I think I don't have a better story than that.
And then the trap house, the toilet. You have to go in and fix the toilet.
Bro, let me tell you about this toilet, though, bro.
I don't remember that.
So apparently the toilet broke, and these girls don't know how to fix the freaking toilet. Now, you flush, inside it has a chain with a little flush on it, right? That pulls the cap up so all the water can come down and you'll flush. The thing was, that I guess like the let's say the little chain or whatever got disconnected. So, you know, if that happens, you can't put it back or whatever. You got to manually do it. All right, man, whatever. But you couldn't do it because there was no more water. So I'm like, look, bro, I ain't no fucking plumber, bro. Like, this shit ain't working. And I guess I don't even know what happened to the bathroom.
It just stopped. We couldn't flush.
So I don't know. I guess.
You fixed it.
Oh, I did?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't remember.
You were pissed.
I was mad for real?
Yeah.
That wasn't to be honest, that was a last minute kind of thing. We had the trip.
Well, I mean, I'm gonna blame that. Tickets. Yeah, I can't blame you.
We had the tickets to park. We had the trip scheduled, and at the last minute, the Airbnb is like, sorry.
I ain't gonna lie though, bro. But like it hasn't been the best. You haven't been the best picker of.
Nah, man.
I ain't gonna lie.
I ain't gonna lie.
You 1,000, bro.
That one was an emergency. The first one went to was really nice.
That shit was dope.
I think it was really nice.
But even then, we fucked up.
Why?
Because you took us to the dope-ass place to stay for one night.
That's not a mess up.
Fuck up.
Nah, hell no.
Yo, that place, you know how much shit that place had?
Yeah.
That place had a lake, a beach, a pool. Like, that shit had everything.
Yeah, that place is
shit had prostitutes, bro. Probably. It probably did. You just didn't know about it, bro. That shit had everything.
Like extracurriculars.
Yeah, that shit had everything. I know, like, the only thing bad about the place was probably the gym.
Yeah.
The gym only had, like two treadmills.
Yeah, like, three things.
That's it, bro.
No, the one that was bad, but that one lied to me through pictures because you even helped me pick. Remember that we saw? That was Eddie, you and me. That one lied to me through the pictures.
Yeah,
he was super nice.
He messed up there too, man.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, what do you think about this one? Because by that time, I had never listened. I picked the one without everybody's consent. And you're like, yo, I'm just going to dope. They say that one.
So we get to this place, right?
That was bad,
man. I'm bad. I'm like, okay. I'm not sure in the bed. There's only two little-ass beds in that shit. I'm like, all right, let's get out. We'll get in another room. So I'm fast with this, right? I feel like you and Eddie were still trying to process like what you guys are about to do because you guys are like, okay. I'm ready to shoot, bro. I don't give a fuck. I'm like, nah, man. See, I'm like, oh, you know, is there any way we could get a room with more beds in it? More beds? She's like, no, they're all the same. I'm like, wait, what? No, they're all the same. So you basically took us to a motel. It's like literally.
The other reason the rate wasn't a motel rate.
And the look of the place, like the lobby was nice.
Yeah,
like,
lobby was mad.
Yeah, like that place is not like a yo.
That place literally sells you through pictures.
Yeah, man, I was like, yo, that's crazy, bro. I mean, if basically Chris had to sleep in a cot, basically
like jail,
and you know, and it worked out. You know, he slept there good. You know, you don't move or nothing. Edge slept on the edge. You don't move or nothing. You could have slept on the bed with Eddie.
Yeah.
Actually, you could have.
That's okay. We worked it out. But yeah, that one, it was like I learned my lesson because I ain't going to base myself on pictures anymore. Because they literally put pictures of all the nice places, which in fact were really nice.
Yeah.
But the rooms themselves, no go.
No goals, buddy. No goals. All right, guys. So I'm not allowed to want to talk anymore. That's it. I'm fucking dying.
Like, so that was a recap of some of our best moments 2018.
We will call this a New Year's music right here. New Year's Eve music. All right, bro. Guys, once again, man, you know, give us an outro, bro. I can't talk no more, man.
Guys, thank you for your support, for your time. We appreciate every listener, every follower, every like, every comment. I think George doesn't make it, but today it was okay. It was nice knowing you. A pleasure. This was I'm down. That was just I'm Chris.
Have a great one.